Hey, good morning, everyone. This is Kirk here again at Option Alpha doing a video update for October 31st. So happy Halloween to everyone. I was going to try to do some cheesy Halloween type stuff like scary stocks, but really wasn't creative enough to put that together. So for all intents and purposes, this is going to be the bare bones type video, not the holiday trading type video for Halloween. So but it is the last day of the month. What a month it's been for stocks, obviously. The S&P almost up 15% last week, about 4%, 4 to 5% across the board. So pretty impressive. So where do we go from here? How do you position yourself? And, you know, who knows? Who knows if it's going to continue, if we're going to see a sell-off. It actually is going along with the 2007-2008 top type scenario, although this current rally has been a little bit faster than what we saw, relatively speaking, in 07-08. So, but still, the same thing happened. We rallied off of relative lows. It looked like it was breaking out lower, reverse course, started heading higher. So let's just take a look at some numbers and see where we're at. Some things that I put together just for you guys and, you know, just kind of give you a little bit of perspective. The top chart up here is S&P 500 stocks that are above their 50-day moving average, and virtually 94% of stocks are above their moving average. This has only happened a couple times in the last 10 years. I think it's three or four times has it been this high. And at some notable tops in the middle of this trend in 2010, obviously 2008, the quick rally that we had in 2009 that got stalled out, 03, 2002, et cetera, et cetera. So stocks are very overextended. At the least, you shouldn't be really jumping in here long if you've missed it. Lord knows we all didn't see this coming. I sure definitely didn't see this coming, as strong and powerful as it was. But you shouldn't be jumping in here now. Things are way overbought. The crowd mentality has definitely set in. And most people that I get emailing me even are talking about how now is a good time to go long, now is a good time to buy. They're, you know, adding more money to the market. And of course, it always seems to be right at the wrong time. We go down to financials, and 100% of the financials are above their 50-day. Now, again, if you look at this chart, the stocks above their 50-day moving average, you can see that back in the beginning part of October, virtually none of them were above their 50-day moving average. So we've come a long way in a short amount of time. You can better believe there's going to be some profit taking. We'll take a look at some of the financials after we take a look at these charts. The biggest thing I think here, down here at the bottom, is job losses in recessions. And you can clearly see which track we've been on here. Is this track here. This I mean, clear outlier. Even some of the deeper parts, or, you know, recessions in the past in 48 and 57, were not even as close as what we're seeing now. And we just have long sustained job loss. And so for me, I think that, you know, it's tricky trading in this market. I was talking to another guy over the weekend, and it's very tricky trading in this market because what you can't factor in is government intervention these days. You know, free market principles are not being let, you know, kind of run the market and run the show. There's so much government intervention, whether it's bailouts, whether it's buybacks, programs, QEs, whatever the case is, that you can't logically factor that in. You know, we don't know when they're going to step in and try to support the market. So we have rallies like this that are seemingly on nothing. We have money managers who are chasing returns now that have had a horrible year and have money on the sidelines that they need to invest. And so most of that is money managers who are chasing returns. They need to put money to work. And so that's why I think we've seen a lot of this. But I think the overall arching trend here is that obviously it's going to get worse at some point. You know, they can't keep putting it off forever. And the more people lose their jobs, the lower the incomes go. Economy like ours that's consumer driven is not going to last. And eventually it's gonna start falling apart again. So be careful, be cautious. Use this time to reallocate your portfolio, to buy some protection, buy some hedges, obviously, because the VIX is low. Option premiums are very, very low on the put side. So use this time wisely to get out of things that have made really substantial moves and are probably not going to make that type of substantial move again. The last thing I want to look at before we look at the chart is commitment of traders. This is another interesting one. If you look here, this is the commitment of traders report of the some of the bigger traders out there. And what they do is compile this on a daily and weekly basis. And what you can see here is this blue line is the net large traders. And most of the net large traders have started to exit. Now, again, most of the net commercial traders have also upped their ante. And this is, again, money managers chasing return. But some of the larger players have actually exited. And they actually exited about a week and a half ago. You can look here and you can see that this chart more or less kind of is right before, usually about a week or two before a big major market move. So you can see that they started really exiting way early. This is the chart of the S&P that corresponds to the chart above. And you can see that the net large traders started getting out much, much earlier than the big fall that we had in August and September. And commercials actually started increasing their bets, not for the better, of course, because the stocks fell. So I usually follow the net large traders when I'm taking a look at this. Of course, this is just one of many indicators that you can use in the market. But it's a really good depiction of where I think things are. You can see that they increased their bets dramatically in the first part of August, which ended up being right near the bottom. So who knows what they're doing now, whether this is just scaling back for the end of the year, taking money out to reposition it elsewhere, but that's what they're doing. If we take a look at the charts, financials, I think, is the big one. This is the XLF, the spider fund for the financials. And of course, here's their move. Dramatic move. Virtually all of them are above their 50-day moving average. We broke out of this region here, which I drew before in my chart and I've talked about in past videos. And you can see it was a clean break. We ran right up to it and then finally broke out of it just last week. So I think the next area that we're headed for is 1450. At that point, I would definitely either think about getting out of your longs in a major way or either getting short some way in the market. It's going to come back down and retrace that move. This is a very strong area, 1450. A lot of support and resistance going back for the last year and a half. So that's going to be a big area. Gold, I think, is hitting some resistance. I'd be hard-pressed to see gold continue to move higher at the rate it has. It's up 6 of the last 7 days, which is pretty impressive just on a statistical standpoint to be up 6 of the last 7 days. So I think gold may actually start to come back lower. We've definitely seen a significant drop-off in gold, and this is looks like it's a typical retracement, just retracing that area that it broke out of and retesting that area. It also happens to be the 50-day moving average, which some people would weigh more heavily in. So futures are slightly lower this morning, about 1% on the S&P. So we'll see where things go. We have a very busy schedule this week as far as earnings, announcements, Fed, payroll, et cetera, et cetera. So make sure that you have everything on track. I left a link to the economic calendar in this post, so you guys can obviously check that out and get all the latest dates, times of announcements, so you guys are always prepared and not surprised by some of these later on in the week. As always, hope you guys enjoy this and happy trading.